Study at online.com/livewire.
Joining us in the studio, a refined palate from a refined woman with a refined denim jacket on. Laurie Forster, the wine coach. Good morning to you, my sweet.
Good morning. Good if I have morning. To get up at 6:30, I'm not going to come in and dress.
We've been here since 4 a.m. Yes, yeah. So...
That would cut into the
blow it
time.
Out your ass!
Your wine hole.
Yes. Well, I think I will.
Oh, yeah.
Well, ooh, I like that, my wine hole.
The wine hole.
So do I, sister.
That needs to be...
What wine goes with Ron Jeremy? I just don't think there's enough.
Rubbing alcohol.
Wine. Yeah, right. Yeah.
Just splash it on whatever hand you shake him with. St. Michael's Winefest, April 26th yes. and 27th.
Absolutely.
What's going on?
Well, you know what's going on is I do a comedic wine tasting because drinking wine and laughing are my two favorite things
Mine
in the world.
Mine too.
Hell yeah.
So I'm doing it on Sunday because Saturday is for amateurs mm-hmm. and Sunday is for professionals.
Nothing like rolling okay. in on a Monday with that yeah. splitting
Take
headache.
Take Monday off.
Yeah.
You're not feeling well.
Not doing a lick of work until noon. Guys, you might want to leave Muriel alone. Something's going on with her.
So at noon, I'm going to kick off the day for everyone with a liquid brunch
nice.
In my show.
Oh, yeah.
We'll taste four wines, we'll have some cheese, just have a lot of fun.
Now, me as a huge fan of hydrocodone, what wine pairs up nicely with a painkiller to really
well,
unlock the true flavor?
I brought you a few today.
Fantastic.
And on the left, or your white wine that you have, sir.
A reliable one.
Is from Anton Bauer. It's from Austria, ooh. And it's called Grüner Veltliner.
Grüner Veltliner.
That's racist.
But that's hard to say. So in Europe, they call it groovy.
Oh, just groovy? It's groovy, man.
And I just think you guys are groovy. So I thought this was perfect white
kind
of kick off our little tasting. It's crisp. It's got some
I'm
great...
I'm not spitting.
Don't, yeah.
Hi there. Isolate
I know.
That.
No talk of spitting.
There we go. Let's take a sip.
Swallow.
Mm-hmm.
It's very good. If you like a Sauvignon Blanc, a Pinot Grigio, this is me,
Veltliner.
The ultimate summer wine, and I'm dreaming of summer.
I'm getting hints of tarragon.
Mm-hmm.
Whoa.
There's a nice daffodil aftertaste.
I'm in recovery, daffodil. So I won't... Oh, yeah.
I tried.
Today.
I tried.
Unfortunately, Josh.
I do respect your decision.
That's a chuggable white,
although
right
I don't
there.
Agree with it.
Mm-hmm. No, it's alcohol seems to mess with my head. It makes me very angry. I'm an angry drunk.
Mm-hmm.
That's all I'll say.
Yeah. Have you guys
very
been
horny.
Over to St. Michael's before?
I have
no,
been to St. Michael's Island.
No?
It's beautiful.
You need to come over.
I definitely
join me.
Do.
I even visited their the winery there. I've been to St.
Oh,
Michael's
okay.
winery and did their tour
They're
and went
awesome.
And saw the casks. Yeah, it was great. They let me take a look around. I actually stayed in bed and breakfast.
Yes.
Nice.
And it
so
was,
the festival will be the whole downtown in St. Michael's, and you can taste. You stop at different shops and restaurants, taste different wines. Of course, if you buy tickets for Sunday for my, you can get a combo ticket. My show, the festival, I have a special little code, Coach 14, and you can do all that for $55.
Dude, that's a bargain.
You drink for the whole day. We just had a bar bill last weekend that was like 200.
Yeah.
55
One round.
The big thing
it's
right now is microbrews, craft beers, people making their own beers.
Yes.
Is this becoming a thing in wine also? Are people making their own wine? Not on like a, I'm not talking like a winery level. I'm talking like in a
small
dude's
scale.
Shed.
In the toilet, in the bathtub.
Well, if you go out to like home, you know, Annapolis homebrew, they have winemaking kits just the same way. That they have beer making kits.
Because I bought a homebrew beer making kit before, and admittedly, I paid attention and did everything they said, and it was awful. It was
well,
so
you
bad.
Can make wine easier than making beer. It's an easier process.
Really?
It really is.
Oh my God, we can make our own hooch.
I want to make it.
We can make our own hooch.
But red wine, I also brought you a
oh,
red.
Oh, let's try this.
I'm a red girl. That's
and
my
I,
favorite.
You know, the first one, groovy fun, but this is called Wild Oats.
I like my wine
sow
black.
Sow them, baby.
Yeah.
Sow them.
Sow your oats with this one. It's a Shiraz, or as they say in Australia, Shiraz.
It's a Shiraz.
Oh.
It's got really great jammy fruit, plum.
Reminds me of my favorite joke.
I thought you guys would like
it. I'm getting a bouquet of lonely aunt. Oh, this pairs up nicely with a murder she wrote.
Oh,
and a long
lovely,
story about
lovely.
How Roger's never coming back. Oh, here we are.
It is kind of crazy how we describe wines, isn't it? It's not mouthwash.
You let it dance over your taste buds.
It's a little oaky.
Oh, that's
oaky.
Good.
It's got a little oak on it.
I love that.
I can taste the booze.
It's called wine.
Turns the bad feelings into good feelings.
See, in the wine world, we have all these really nice terms that make it sound better. It's not booze. It's wine. It's not drinking. It's tasting.
And we're tasting it.
So it doesn't matter that you're tasting at 8 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
Hmm? It's a professional kind of thing.
There's certain cultures that start their day with wine. For example, Bowie. Glen Burnie. Children are weaned.
I just
did
a great event over in Bowie the other day.
I bet it was amazing.
It was amazing.
God's country. Bowie. What else did you bring?
Luncheon.
You brought some stuff besides wine. You had some cider, some dessert ciders?
I did. I brought a peanut butter caramel.
What?
My cider. You got to make room in one of your glasses or give him another glass so we can, Sarah and...
I'm a cider girl. I cannot wait to try this. Peanut butter, caramel, apple cider.
It's delicious.
It sounds amazing.
It really is.
Mike, let me get a sniff on that. I'm not sure if I can do
it. What got you into this?
Like, well, I used to be in sales and taking clients out to dinner, fancy dinner, wine, and I was a beer drinker at the time. So I just started taking classes at a cook's table, if you remember that place.
Laurie Forster, the wine coach, joins us. St. Michael's Wine Fest, April 26th, 27th. And the thing I noticed about this cider first, it doesn't have the same hue as the ciders I drink, like a woodchuck, like a, Strongbow?
Yeah, Strongbow. That's Strongbow.
It's definitely lighter, paler in color.
It resembles a nice Zima, 1985.
Now this, wait, I want you to taste it, and then guess where this is made.
Antarctica. There we go.
No. Don't forget, we're giving away two tickets to the Sunday Festival, my show, and the festival.
You really get the peanut butter and the caramel.
Oh, my God. It's like drinking a Reese's cup.
Delicious.
With
it's
booze
awesome.
In it.
You've had that DeClaw Sweet Baby Jesus.
Oh, yes.
I have.
But that's really heavy. This is not so heavy. It's nice.
Like, I could drink a glass of this. Some of the problems with some of those dessert beers, dessert wines, even though I like a port, is that you can have a sip or two,
but
anything beyond that, you're like, God, it's sitting heavy in my gut.
This is like made the double in chocolate Hershey, beers. Pennsylvania.
It makes sense.
Yep.
I'm getting the chocolate. I'm getting the peanut butter. I'm getting the slight taste of Amish.
Vineyard at Hershey.
Ooh.
So
you can ride a roller coaster and drink some cider.
Exactly. Oh. On our sister station, I do a radio show called The Sipping Point.
Yes, you do.
All about food and wine. Michael.
Michael Anderson.
Me.
As he has long time.
He used to be my producer, then he left me. But we're having the Vineyard at Hershey on because they're doing a great festival in May. But right now I'm all about the St. Michael's. But every weekend you can go to a festival.
Now we have Easter. This Sunday, people stopping by, visiting relatives, visiting family, visiting friends, and it is custom to bring somebody
a house gift,
a nice bottle. For those that might be stopping by their local liquor store, the local wine distributor, give a good wine, give a good price. What should they bring that is a nice offering that's not going to break the bank?
Well, I mean, I think both of these, they both retail under $16. So we have the Wild Oats Shiraz. Excellent.
The Shiraz is my favorite.
The Anton Bauer Groovy, it's kind of geeky, but I'm a wine geek. Okay. But it's fun, and people love it. They're both screw caps. But I think sparkling wine.
Your screw cap.
Yeah.
I like mine in a bag.
Sparkling wine, maybe like an Italian Prosecco is a great wine.
Nothing wrong with bubbles.
It's affordable.
A nice Charles Schull.
Mianetto makes a great one. Pinot Noir for ham, if that's what you do for Easter. Excellent.
Anything for 420?
420.
420.
I just got back from Denver, and I
Good
didn't know
job.
What 420 meant, and I finally
what?
Got
you
schooled.
You didn't know what
How
420
did you,
meant?
Yeah.
I know. I'm
Even
a
I know.
Have you seen the internet?
I called my assistant. I said, hey, I'm on the 420 to Denver. She's like, oh, that's funny. I'm like, no, seriously, it was a 4:20 p.m. flight from Baltimore to Denver.
I wonder if they do that on purpose.
100%.
I thought they did as a joke.
Lori, did you take pot while you're out there? Did you take pot?
I did
because
not.
Because it's available.
But they're having a big festival on 420 where everybody's going to be able to smoke in the middle of an arena or something.
You know what? Someone was asking, Nick Notar on Twitter was asking me about different themed wines, wrestling-themed wines, what have you. What is the possibility of one of the things we do, we send people on this 420 tour to Denver, Colorado, being that it's now legalized out there.
Nice.
Fully legal, and they do these cooking classes where they show how you can remove the oils from it and cook with it. I got to wonder, what's the possibility of removing some THC oils and putting them
they already do that.
Inside
there
a wine?
There is pot wine.
Is there pot wine?
There is pot wine.
Oh, yeah.
It's not something I've ever had,
the
but I have read about it.
They make heroin lemonade. Daddy's on board.
98online.com.